it. Your hands usually supply the monitoring report as of March 31st, and I'm just wondering where that is.
Mr. Chair, we haven't, I don't believe we looked at that yet, but I'll talk to them before next meeting.
Is it not a requirement to have it completed by the 31st of March?
It is not whatsoever a requirement. We've been providing it to the CMC and to the ministry without a requirement. The requirement comes in when the site is not ready.
Okay, and the other question I have is regarding the County of Simcoe's report that we've received. I believe the committee asked for an itemized bill. We have no idea of the numbers attached to this or what may be omitted or what this really includes. And I'm wondering if you're going to supply us with further data as to what this total amount has been incurred.
No, that was not. What was agreed to by council was this. I don't believe their resolution, if you recall, the resolution came from the CMC asking for this. Council, county council handled it in saying that it would be provided, essentially there would be a report done to them, which this is.
A supplementary to the chair, previously we have received itemized bills from the companies that actually were listed, and I think this is similar to the MOTFO or any other information, if the data isn't there as to, I don't know what the security costs were from last year, I don't know what things might be omitted from this, and I kindly request the CMC ask for a breakdown of the actual costs. So it actually says in the motion here, staff have prepared the following cost breakdown. This isn't a breakdown at all, this is just a total.
What's the breakdown by year?
To be fair, if I put my taxes in, it wouldn't be by the year for my tax amount that I would submit. And I think it's very relevant that for Bill 32, if it were passed, it's very important that a final total be presented to the province of Ontario that they may consider funding some sort of refund to the County of Simcoe that we have an accurate reflection of the numbers. It did not include legal or other, there were certain things Bill 32 doesn't cover, and so to have a breakdown of where the county's expenses, I think, is very important, and as a taxpayer, I feel this is irresponsible and not with enough detail for the committee members, because we wanted to send this out with our annual report. And I don't think this is enough for the public to understand what was spent last year.
Here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No,
Mr. Chair, I think we've been through this conversation 2 years ago. We asked about it in the fall of 2008, how much a couple firms got, and we did not get the answer back then, so for some reason the county is very secretive, so we're kind of beating the dead horse here, I think. Thank you.
Okay, I still would like a suggestion that you just put a motion on the floor to ask for it. And I would suggest that many county councillors might feel that they've already passed a resolution that we receive this kind of detail report, unfortunately. I'm sure the Heritage or the Museum Committee and all the other committees at county don't receive this type of reporting on projects they're undertaking. Thank you.
To the chair, I just wanted to talk about this letter from UMass and Cartwright. I have a question on it. It goes back. Actually, the question will end up being with Rob. On September 11th, Robin Collard had advised me that the total expenditures on withholding the module was $11,068.50. And so, since that time, in the last week or so, all of this information has come to light with UMass and Cartwright's FOI. And so I was able to go and get copies from you, and I need to ask Rob where he got that number from, $11,068.50. because right now I'm having some troubles getting any updated numbers because it's difficult.
I don't recall the 1106850. You might leave this in January this year or January?
September of 2008.
I don't recall.
Okay, so what I did, I went through the invoices that were supplied to you and to Cartwright, and up to that date, we see total invoices of $54,967 have been spent as of that date. And more recently, I asked you for information, and we've had some emails back and forth, and it hasn't been very fruitful for me getting this information. And you said there was no lists and things like that. And in fact, the warden had sent an index of records December 31st. With a perfect list of everything up until last September, with actual file numbers from Marshall Green that total $112,686. So now I'm being told there's no lists, and I'm going to have to pay to research all this. $220 is what the county wants from a member of the CMC to get this information that was supplied by you at no cost a couple of years ago. And of course, I've asked what's happened. I'm not getting any answers from the county on this, so I'm sharing this information with you. Plus, I went through the invoices and some emails that were supplied, and I can see where there was directions from Mr. Greenwood, who's in the communications, that went up to a couple of lawyers in Toronto for assistance in publishing some material in September. And it included your module, and they're not in the invoice list, so it's incomplete. So I wouldn't put a lot of confidence in these numbers that we're getting, because they're not all here. And you'll know that since September 30th, the county has expended money in order to negotiate with Genevar to fight for a stay and to prepare the perfection of the evidence for divisional court. So it's anybody's guess as to how much money is being spent. And one thing for sure, the county doesn't believe I have the wherewithal to figure out how to figure their accounting system out. So I think it should be obvious to all of us that they don't want us to know how much money is being spent. So that's the statement and the answer. I have my answer. Thank you.